Entrance controls activated.
Wraps. Let's clear this sulfur sod and fucks out so Hayes can rest in peace.
Thank you.
Hayes was the best self-sacrificing son of a saint I ever met. Halcyon is worse off without him. Now, if we're gonna lure the Manta Queen out, we'll need to find Rebecca and Anders. They took a UDL contract on Terra 2. We never heard from them again. Think it's time I call in a favor with Hiram. If anyone can track them down, it's him. I don't know much about it. It paid well, so they took it. They said they'd be back in a couple of weeks and that maybe we could all use the money to get off Monarch. That was a long time ago. I should have. I really should have. But soon after they left, Hayes and the others died. And to be honest, after him, I stopped trying. Because it hurt like... Thanks. I'm still not convinced I won't come to regret it, but... We've started down this path. Might as well see it through. Maybe it'll stop me screaming at night. Now come on. Let's make tracks before Hiram dies of old age. The caves back east are safest. We can head up this path if you want to shoot your way through a few nightmares on your way up.
Warning! Organic debris stuck in tread. Please remove organic debris from tread. Unit is ill-suited to rocky environment. Update! Organic debris dislodged from tread.
It is a tread.
Industrial stay!
And here we are. Told you we'd make it in one piece. Station ain't too far now.
Hey you! Get over here! There are marauders up ahead! This station's under the protection of the corporate compliance crew. You a marauder? 'Cause me and my sunshine, that's my gun if you were wondering. We don't take kindly to marauders. A coherent enough response, I reckon. Must be true. You're clear, but I would caution you against pressing on ahead. This station's plumb crawling with marauders, you know. I take it you ain't met the other C3s. Me and Sunshine are doing exactly what we've been tasked with. You want more details? You ought to talk to my crew. They're guarding a small barracks to the southeast, by the edge of the mountain. There is nothing I'd enjoy more, but the C3s play it by the book. Usually. Go petition the boss man. Maybe you can convince him to alter my duties. See that path that runs underneath that giant archway? Follow it on down. There's a little station near the cliff. You'll find the rest of my crew there.
Making tracks. Easy.
Thank you. approaching! I shark C3!
On the alert, ladies and gents. We got us a live one.
How'd you get up here? Through the caves? Good answer. I wasn't looking forward to gut-shotting you. See, the thing is, I'm with the corporate compliance crew. C3, if you will. We're mercs. And our current contract mandates that we annihilate any creatures or persons that emerge from the tunnel.
Allow me to intervene. It's my job to mediate any conflicts of interest regarding C3 and third parties. All right. First things first. To make a decision in this dispute, I'm gonna need to know what your role in your organization is. A lean but efficient corporate structure. I'm impressed. Still, I gotta wonder. What are your intentions regarding dev- Well, that's all well and good, but the reason you've come is secondary to the arbitration at hand. Our guidelines allow us some leeway in identifying threats to our client. Your unorthodox profession makes me think we ought to remove you from the premises permanently. However, the terms of our contract specifically targets marauders, iconoclasts, MSI operatives, and anyone deemed to hobo-like in appearance. As you don't appear to fit any of those categories, I'm afraid I can't quite make a call on you.
Don't we, as a standing policy, provide an alternative to termination via financial restitution? Addy, our chief financial officer, could confirm, but I'm betting if you're willing to compensate us for our lost time and productivity due to this arbitrage, I guess we might could. There's something I like about you. Can't put my finger on it, but I feel like I'd rather have you with us than against us. All right. Lance, unless you have a final point of contention to make, I'd say he's clear to go.
Nah. I'll sign the clearance form. Just... I must advise you to steer clear of Devil's Peak Station. It's teeming with marauders.
Anything else you need? Trying to say we didn't do our job? I'll have you know, our contract was to stop any marauders coming from the caves. Didn't say nothing about the ones taking the mountain path. We'll simply clear them out later, once we've got the go-ahead from Berthold. That's right. Berthold Fox is our boss man, founder, president, and CEO. Birdie went down into the caves on a hunt for marauders, give or take, 6 hours ago. He's a hands-on type. Likes to handle the tougher tasks himself. Although, he should have been back, going on 6 hours now. I'd ask you to check the caves for him, but then we'd have to kill you when you crawl back out. Done. Use this. Signal's locked to Birdie's tracker. Should lead you right to him. Or his body. Whatever you find. Bring him back to us, okay?
As a purely hypothetical thought exercise, if I were to boil leather in manti blood to give it a nice purple hue, is there a way to get the stench out afterward?
Recommended dry cleaning service for fabric type, incineration. sanitize.
Here I go. Moving.
Competition.
Making tracks. I'm going. Will do, Captain.
Moving to destination.
The hell? Look up. What's he doing up there?
This unit's middle name.
I'm going.
That assist was a violation of corporate law if I ever saw one. Since it was to my benefit, and we're largely in lawless lands, I'll look the other way. C3 owes you one, stranger. You haven't seen Constance, have you? Ah, there's her torso. And that'll be her legs over yonder, never mind. I'm Bertold.
What in the void are you thinking, creeping around a mana queen like that?
At the time, I was thinking, please don't see me, hola, I don't want to die, nah. Now I'm thinking it was stupid to come in here. Means it's still holding the post then. Good. You might head on back. We can talk more there where it's safe. I'll be on my way. Once I've gathered up Constance's parts.
Thank you.
industrial stain. Congratulations, customer. Your SAM unit is performing at peak capacity. Complete. reminder, large jobs take Sam longer to clean.
To be honest, I'm surprised it's still standing. Every time I set foot inside, I half expect the tower to fall over.
Hey, Mannequin Slayer. Glad you made it in one piece. After all, not everyone's so lucky. Meet my corporate compliance crew. Then check out our weapons locker inside. I reckon you'll find something you like. Then we call it even between us. We were hired to do so. Why else? You did get the memo that we're mercenaries. Our client's a bit unorthodox, sure. He calls himself the Broker, and prefers the glow of a terminal to flesh and blood interaction. But I can't fault his work ethic. Our current gig's to stop, by means of lethal force, any creatures exiting the caverns, including but not limited to You drive a hard bargain, Mannequin Slayer. It don't make much financial sense for C3 to expend resources on any killing beyond the contract stipulations. As the Marauders didn't enter from the caves, the requirements are murky. At the same time, we do want to keep our client alive until the payment's cleared. We recommended the client safeguard himself, so I don't expect that the main doors will be accessible. Find a way to open them, and we'll clear any hostiles on the inside. I best radio ahead for Joy and Hudson to prep for us. They'll be at the station entrance, ready with our finest auto mechanicals to assist you. C3s, prepare to move out.
There you are. Bossman said you'd be... Fox radioed ahead. Said I'm to follow you. Provide whatever support you need. If those bastards start shooting, we'll join in. I gotta warn you, my girl Sunshine here is a tad trigger-happy. Of course, me and her will follow your lead. Just wanted you to know we wouldn't begrudge you of any violent inclinations. Ain't it the same, really? I'd say me and my piece meet each other halfway on the issue. She likes to be used, and I like to put her to good use. As so very often as I can. We can tell friend from foe, mind you, but it's probably best not to walk directly in front of us. Whatever you need, just don't take too long. Idling makes me want to shoot something. Go on ahead. C3's got your six. Fighting ain't gonna get easier on the inside. Best hurry before the Marauders break.
Hiram must have sealed the door. He spooks easy.
may not realize this, being as you're an outsider, but the blaring alarms indicate the station's on lock.
Here's the elevator, but ain't gonna budge while this place is on lockdown. Guess we keep moving forward. Look for another way up.
intercom. I can't tell if you're brave or simply touched in the head. What in the galaxy are you doing sniffing around my station? Unless you are, in fact, trying to suicide by Marauder? And you, Nioka, what are you doing lugging a stranger into my station?
You could use the socialization, you son of a bitch. Also, he hired me.
To what purpose? I happen to have some significant problems I am dealing with right now. Marauders? Running out of purple berry wine 3 days ago, not being able to bloody broadcast. No. We'll deal with information-related business later. As I said, there are bigger problems threatening my life and livelihood at this very moment. The Marauders want me dead. And since my hired hands have clearly turned idle, it appears I need you to clear out the threat. As my newest contractor, you may call me the Broker.
Or we can call you Hiram, on account of that's your damn name, and doubly on the account of the Broker being a dumbass alternative.
What? Everyone calls me that, aside from you. See, Nioka? I barricaded the broadcast center, but I can only hold out for so long. Clear the Marauders out, and I'll pay you double the going rate. They destroy the transmission equipment, and I'll be out of business. The elevator and doors to the second floor are back online. Hurry before I have to lock them down again. Too many, considering I hired a bunch of no-good mercs to keep them out in the first place. Already, they've caused considerable damage to the station's property. If they take down the broadcast equipment, I'll be out of a job, permanently. Aside from the bits I'll be paying you, you said you wanted...
Light them on fire, ladies and gents!
Enforcing compliance is just busy work. Damn it.
Smell something.
Waste of nothing.
Waste of company ammo.
Never thought I'd be ecstatic at having the walls painted in blood, but seeing as it's not mine, I'd say this calls for a celebration. And you got me my money's worth out of the C3s. I ought to have simply dealt with you in the first place. Yes, I believe I do. This ought to square our debt. One hefty payment for a highly valued service rendered. But, I admit, I do wonder why Nioka has brought you to me. Allow me to pose my question in another manner. Why, in the Nebula, are you here? Ah, yes. Our little chat on the intercom. You're looking for the premier broker for all of Monarch, which you knew was me, clearly. Phineas must have sent you. He's the only one insane enough to send someone to Monarch to rush me. I knew it was only a matter of time before he came a-knocking. Look, I might be late, but I fulfill my contracts, always.
Oh, you do, do you? I have lost track of the number of beers you owe me for chasing raptodons off your stoop.
SAM units never need longer than necessary to complete the job. Quick, quiet, and efficient, SAM sees it done.
I take offense to that. Look, okay. Just, it might take me a while this time. I am awaiting but a single incoming transmission containing the information we desire. But MSI and the Iconoclasts are clogging the airwaves from Stellar Bay and Amber Heights. In their war against each other, they're scrambling each other's outgoing transmissions. Luckily, however, MSI has now gone silent. You wouldn't know anything about that, would you? A pity. Seems I have some information on a rogue agent to hunt down. Still, we need to get the Iconoclasts off the airwaves. I will leave the means of that particular end under your discretion. Exactly what I was thinking. They hurt us all with their pettiness. Which, of course, has inadvertently affected the incoming port and my livelihood. Amber Heights is one of the only surviving settlements outside of Stellar Bay. Graham Bryant and the Iconoclasts there got their hands on a working relay station. Now they're ceaselessly transmitting philosophist ramblings on my airwaves. No, they're jamming the limited frequencies we have at our disposal. Nothing extraplanetary can get in or out until the frequency pollution thins out. The safest bet is to convince Graham and his Iconoclasts to stop transmitting on their end. You do that, I'll be here, waiting on the receiving end. Luck be with you. I have a feeling you'll be needing a pinch of it, plus a vat of patience. Oh, great. I love doing pro bono work for friends.
Aw, you called us friends. I'd normally entertain your self-aggrandizing delusions, but this time it's important.
Important to you is not the same as important to me. Although I do recognize that you may have earned some... Whoa, hey, there is zero need for violence in this station. Look, I'll do what I can, all right?
Rebecca Hodges and Anders Wadsworth. They took a UDL contract back when Monarch went to shit, and I need to find them. I believe them to be on Terra 2.
If UDL hired two hunters back then, it would have been for creature clearing purposes, round one of their Spacer's Choice outposts. These are the coordinates for the outpost under the last UDL contract. Now scram. And, good luck. Sure. You know where to find me if you need me.
Bloodbath like that calls for a celebratory drink.
Sure, I'm glad the station's under control again. Means we get po-
Marauder is a dead or dying one.
Old's quiet again. Thanks for the easy payday, stranger. Maybe C3 ought to hire you.